Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about the differences between Aplos and QuickBooks, and really, fund accounting software versus non-fund accounting software. My name is Alex Acree, and I'm the head of the services department with Aplos. So today what we're going to take a look at is some of the workarounds that people will do in QuickBooks in order to compensate for the lack of fund accounting in that system. In order to accomplish fund accounting in QuickBooks or any non-fund accounting software, you have to put in multiple workarounds in order to get the information you need on the reports. So just want to say up front that we are not affiliated with QuickBooks at all. In fact, we're Aplos. And really, QuickBooks is a great program. If you run a small business or a medium-sized business, QuickBooks is fantastic. They have a ton of features, very affordable. But really, what we're talking about here is if you are a nonprofit, church, or government entity, you have to do what's called fund accounting. And it's just a core difference in the way that accounting works. Some softwares are built for it, some are not. We are, they are not. So what we're going to do today is just go over some of those differences and some of the workarounds that you might have seen or might have done to do in QuickBooks in order to compensate for the lack of fund accounting. So one of the main workarounds in QuickBooks that people will do in lack of having fund accounting is to set up multiple subaccounts to represent the different cash balances that they need to track. So let's say you have a checking account. In Aplos, that does fund accounting, you would have one checking account in Aplos to represent your checking account balance at the bank, which is right. In Aplos, because we have different funds, you'll be able to see that that total amount of money that you have is then segregated or separated for the different fund cash balances that you need to track. With QuickBooks, you can't do the same thing. You have to set up multiple subaccounts underneath that checking to represent one account per fund cash balance. So you'd have something like checking, then a subaccount for general checking, and then a subaccount for missions checking, subaccount for building checking, all of these subaccounts representing each cash balance. The sum of those is the total cash balance. So you've got it somewhere, but it's split across all of these subaccounts that you then need to track separately and reconcile separately. Or if you're trying to reconcile them together, it's kind of a nightmare because that's a lot of work. And that's only for one account, so that's checking. So then if you need to have, you know, general missions and building money in also savings, now you've got even more subaccounts to deal with. So that is one of the core workarounds that people will end up doing to keep their cash separate. But again, that's only for the cash balance, and that's subaccounts per account. So it's quite a lot of work to just get to how much money is in my bank right now for this fund. So some of the drawbacks about having this workaround for multiple subaccounts to represent the different cash balances in QuickBooks is it's not a true kind of look at what cash balance you have in your checking is overall. So you might have $1,000 in there and you want to see checking equals $1,000. But if you have that $1,000 split up across multiple subaccounts, it's hard to get to that core total. Another one is it requires you to have the same workaround for every cash account that you need to track different balances in. So again, you might have a checking and a savings or multiple checkings, and you'd need to have multiple subaccounts for each. So now you're looking at kind of a big grid just to see what your totals are. And kind of the last kind of downside to this is only for cash. This is not for accounts receivable, any other kind of asset, any other kind of liability. So really it's just focused on your cash balances. So it's very limited. So not only is it pretty complicated to work with, it's also very limited in what it actually covers. So another workaround in QuickBooks to compensate for the lack of fund accounting is to use classes to track your fund's activity. So a class is a feature, it's a parameter that you set up in QuickBooks and then attach to transactions for income and expenses. The benefit is you can track how much has come in and come out for this thing, this class. The downside is that only shows you kind of the net, you know, like the income statement result. It shows you what's come in and what's gone out, which is great, but downsides. It's only for income and expense. So it doesn't track any sort of liability payment, any receipt or purchase of any kind of other asset. So it's limited to just your income statement and not your balance sheet. It also doesn't carry any sort of balance. So if last year you had a class set up for your missions fund and you made $1,200, that $1,200 is not left in that class. It's just that year's report shows that you made $1,200. So if you need to get to how much does my fund have, you'd have to run a report for all dates and then do the math to see what you started with, what was the activity, and so what is my kind of ending fund balance. Pair that with the other workaround that we talked about, which is the multiple cash account workaround thing. So now you've got a class to track your activity so you can see how much has come in and gone out, but now you have to then match that or reconcile that to, did that happen in my missions fund checking account or my missions fund savings account? How much money did I have at the beginning of the year? Well, I don't know. It's the sum of these cash accounts put together, but then this activity affects it. And again, that's only for income and expense. So never mind if you had to pay off some sort of loan or accounts payable or receive an invoice, none of that would count either. So the difference with Aplos and QuickBooks in this is Aplos tracks all the income and expenses for the fund, just like a class does. But with every transaction that you enter in Aplos, you're picking the account that's impacted, but you're also picking what fund it's coming in or out of. So when you pick that, you're saying this expense came out of this fund balance in this cash account. So with every transaction that you're entering, you're not only tracking the activity on the fund, but you're also impacting the current fund balance in whatever account you're working in. Last kind of note too is Aplos does have an equivalent feature of a class and we call it a tag. It's essentially the same thing. If you have some sort of event or fundraiser or team or department or location, one of these things that you need to track in more detail, that's not a fund and it's not an account, but you want to see how much has come in or out for it, you can also use a tag in Aplos to add some extra detail to it. So another main workaround that people will do, and this is the last one pretty much, is equity adjusting balances at the end of the year. So what I mean by that is, let's play out the other two examples. Let's say that you've got the cash accounts set up to represent the cash values that you got for each fund. So that's one workaround in place. And then you have a class in there so that you can track the income and the expenses. So that's in there. So now you can get to how much cash did I have at the beginning and at currently, I guess, at the end. What's the activity in between? But the downside, again, is that's only impacting cash and income and expense. It has nothing to do with other assets and liabilities at all. And that doesn't result in an ending equity balance that you need for each fund. So what some people will do is say, we started with this much cash, we had this much activity from the class, right? So hypothetically, our ending fund balance at the end of the year should be the beginning minus the activity or plus the activity. So you do an adjusting entry balance at the end of the year to then reclassify your equity into one of those other buckets. So the downside with this is, for anyone that doesn't have a CPA license or an accounting degree, what I just said makes absolutely no sense. So to actually use this as a user is going to be very, very difficult unless you want to pay for someone to do it for you, which is an option. The other downside to this is it also still doesn't get you to what is this fund's balance. Let's say that I've got five different funds. Two of them restricted, three are unrestricted. I want to get to how much does this fund have in it right now. It's not necessarily cash only because there might be McGinn receivables or fixed assets or liabilities against it. So let's say I can finally get to, okay, at the end of the year, this is my ending fund balance. I do the adjustment, I put it into some sort of unrestricted, temporarily restricted or unrestricted net assets category. But that is also now just bucketing these things into those three. Not necessarily your missions fund balance is this. So then you go to a separate spreadsheet, most likely, to say, well, on my balance sheet, we have this much restricted money, and that's actually these funds together. Well, I mean, you can do that, but again, that's just, it's almost like a fourth workaround is Excel, right? So you not only have to make all of this workaround for the cash accounts, which again is just cash, you have the classes, track activity, and then you have to do some sort of end of the year roll up into an equity account that doesn't represent the balance. That balance is actually the sum of these things over here, which hopefully that equals that, because I've seen spreadsheets that have way more fund money allocated to them than the accounting actually does. And that's because there's multiple stop gaps. You have to do all kinds of workarounds for it. And it, at the end of the day, is just not fund accounting. So why is Aplos a good fit for this rather than QuickBooks? Now, for the record, we've been using QuickBooks as kind of the term to compare to, but really what we're meaning here is non-fund accounting software. We use QuickBooks because that's kind of synonymous with accounting software, but realistically, we just mean non-fund accounting software. It could be anything. QuickBooks is actually an incredible program if you run a small business. And in fact, we see a lot of comparisons about us and QuickBooks saying, you know, this is great for small businesses, but Aplos falls short for small businesses, which is right. That's not what we're made for. Equal comparison is Aplos is great for nonprofits, QuickBooks isn't, and that's right because they weren't made for that. So really at the end of the day, our main kind of demographic here is nonprofits, which typically includes smaller organizations and religious affiliated, you know, churches and stuff. So the kind of the core demographic of those users are not people that have a lot of experience in accounting. They also don't have a ton of money to throw at hiring someone to perform these things. So it's for this exact reason that we have wanted to create Aplos and provide a simple and affordable fund accounting solution for that demographic, because QuickBooks or any non-fund accounting software just falls short in some areas. And what you guys really need is a true core fund accounting product that's catered to the exact needs that you've got as an organization. So that's why we're here. So hopefully this content was helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to use the comments box below or subscribe if you want more videos from us. We can also provide any answers to you from our support email, support@aplos.com. Be more than happy to go through any questions with you.